August of 2008, I took a trip over the last half of the Oregon Trail. That extends from the southeast corner of Idaho to Oregon City, just south of Portland. That's about 1,000 miles, which is half of the total length of the Oregon Trail. I started in Montpelier in the southeast corner of Idaho. There is an excellent Oregon Trail Interpretive Center there. Actors depict some of the challenges that face the homesteaders. Here are a few of the milestones relating to the Oregon Trail. We were in Montpelier on August 12th and 13th, 2008. In 1896, on August 13th, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid and their gang did their first bank robbery in Montpelier, Idaho. Here's a sign in Montpelier that tells about the robbery. Here's a few views of the countryside west of Montpelier. In the days that the homesteaders went across it, there was mainly sagebrush. Now there are farms. There's both dry farming and irrigation in that area. We went on through Soda Springs, which was one of the points that the homesteaders passed through, and the next stop was Fort Hall. Currently, there's a replica of Fort Hall in Pocatello. The original Fort Hall was submerged now in the American Falls Reservoir. West of Pocatello, we came to Massacre Rocks. This is the point that during the 1860s, a group of homesteaders were massacred by their Indians as they passed through these two outcroppings of rock. Here's a view of the Snake River near Massacre Rocks. As the homesteaders proceeded west, they stayed south of the Snake River. They came to the Snake River Canyon, which is 500 feet deep. It was important that each day they have a stop where they could get water. If they couldn't find a stream, they had to use water in the barrels on the side of their wagons. About 100 miles further west, they came to Three Island Crossing, which was the point they crossed over the Snake River to go northwest. That made the trip shorter. Although they could get across at Three Island Crossing, it was dangerous. A number of people lost horses and some people drowned. Second Saturday of every August, there is a reenactment of the crossing at Three Island Crossing. I saw that reenactment this year. From Three Island Crossing, the homesteaders would go northwest across the desert. On a butte about 10 miles east of the current Boise, they could look and see woods in the far distance. From there, the Oregon Trail proceeds into Oregon. There's an excellent interpretive center about 5 miles from Baker City. There's still lots of sagebrush in that area. The ruts from the original Oregon Trail can still be seen in that sagebrush. Northwest of Baker City, the homesteaders could look across the valley and see the Blue Mountains. After passing through the Blue Mountains, they would come to the Columbia River. At that point, their choice was to take a raft down the Columbia River or continue on the trail going through the mountains near Mount Hood. Then they would reach the end of their destination, which was Oregon City. That's located just south of Portland. There was some wood in that area so they could build a shack looking like this one. The homesteaders could average about 10 to 12 miles a day. The way they determined how much mileage they made was to try a rag at the top of one of the spokes on one of the wheels of the wagon. They would have one of the children count the revolutions. 400 revolutions made 1 mile. Later, someone devised a gear mechanism that would count the revolutions. Although it cost a little bit, you only needed one for each wagon train. About 1 in 10 of the homesteaders died on the trail. A lot of them died from cholera caused by bad water, and also some from Indian attacks. Surprisingly, a number died from self-inflicted gunshot wounds. A big inducement to the homesteaders was the land that they would get at the end of the trail. Each man was awarded 160 acres of land, but also each woman was awarded 160 acres. So a man and wife could get 320 acres, whereas in states in the East, only the man got the 160 acres. Next summer, I hope to make a trip over the first half of the Oregon Trail.